Well, the commencement of Chestnut Hill College for the classes of 2020 and 2021, please come to order. Good morning and welcome home. Joining us via live streaming locally, nationally, and globally. Our procession was led by the American, state, and papal flags. Following was the Ukrainian flag in support of those affected by the current conflict. We keep the Ukrainians in our hearts and prayers as they defend their democracy. Representing Chestnut Hill College's global diversity were the flags of France and Ireland. The flag bearers are students who studied abroad in these countries during their time at Chestnut Hill. As we gather today, I would like to take a moment to thank graduates, family, faculty, staff, and honored guests who are medical personnel, active and retired military, police officers, firefighters, and frontline workers. Please stand to be recognized. Thank you for all you do for our country and for our communities. We gather to recognize the accomplishments of the classes of 2020 and 2021 and to formally award them degrees they have earned through their hard work and commitment to academic endeavors. Both we and they have great reason to be proud to be able to gather today in person on this great day of celebration and rejoicing. The invocation will be delivered by Kenyatta Burton, BS, Class of 2021, School of Continuing and Professional Studies. Jennifer Miller, BS, Class of 2020, School of Undergraduate Studies, will lead us in the singing of the National Anthem. Please remain standing for the invocation and the National Anthem.
Good morning. Please pray with me. Our Father God, how wonderful are the works of your hands. As we gather here today to celebrate a step forward into new places with new people and new experiences, let us not forget the blessings that follow behind us. For this school, which has given us a safe place to learn, and a strong foundation to build upon as we take this next step into your world. For our teachers who have so richly loved and cared for us even at our worst. For our families who have cheered us on to the finish line and stood by our side through the many bumps in the road. And on this day especially, we thank you for the friends that we have found among our classmates. For all the jokes that we will laugh about in years to come, for all the hardships and tears we have endured together side by side, and your love has been made evident through the relationships we will carry with us beyond these walls. Just as our school verse says, let us continue to lay down our lives for each other, just as you gave up your life for each of us. Let us love each other fearlessly, and seek you earnestly all the days of our lives. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Stripes and bright stars.
Thank you. Please be seated. I am pleased to introduce Catherine Lockyer Moulton, BA 92, MS 22, Chair of the Board of Directors, to offer the greetings.
Good morning. If it's okay with you, I'm going to do things a little bit outside of the generally accepted protocol for this welcome address because we find ourselves in a unique situation today. So for those who stand on ceremony, pro forma, and procedure, please forgive me. Class of 2020, class of 2021, at long last, welcome to your commencement ceremony. You have arrived. We also welcome your dear family and friends who have supported you throughout your college career and since your graduation. Your journey as graduates' support network has had its own unique challenges. We honor you for your sacrifice and your unwavering support. Now on to the formalities. Sister Carol Jean Vale, Sisters of St. Joseph, Board of Directors, Administration, Faculty, Staff, volunteers, we welcome you to this momentous occasion and we thank you for creating this space for celebration. Without your vision and your creative energy, we know that this day would not have been possible, and we are grateful. The East Indian philosopher Ramana Maharshi said once, "No one succeeds without effort. Those who succeed owe their success to perseverance." Well, you all have persevered through tough times. Getting through college is no easy task. Your ability to balance family, friends, work, academics, maybe even a social life, is not something that any of us take lightly. And that is all during normal times. Yet we know that your time here at college has been anything but ordinary. You faced obstacles of the pandemic and identified paths to overcome those obstacles again and again and again. In our home, we say steel becomes stronger after it has been fired. You are stronger today because of all that you have experienced. You have learned what books cannot teach you. You have learned to stare down the obstacles before you, to think creatively, to have optimism when the world seems dark, and to push forward despite everything that faces you. We, the administrators, board, faculty, and staff are all so exceedingly proud of you for all that you have accomplished. We recognize your valor in uncommon times. We are grateful for your cooperation as we all work together to identify new creative methods, and we celebrate you for your achievements. God bless you all. Congratulations.
Thank you, Catherine. Maybe one day one of you will be chair of the board of directors. It's possible. I'm pleased to introduce Samantha Covius, BA, class of 2020, School of Undergraduate Studies, who will offer the welcome on behalf of all undergraduates. Sam?
Good morning, Sister Carol, members of the board, faculty, staff, family, friends, and most importantly, the Chestnut Hill College classes of 2020 and 2021. It's certainly been a while, but I am so happy that we're back. So I want to kick off this graduation ceremony by stating something that I'm pretty sure we all know. Nowhere on earth will you find somewhere like Chestnut Hill College. Nowhere will you find a college whose staff members invite you into their home for a pasta dinner, whose faculty will cheer you on when you get that acceptance to grad school or lead the basketball team in three-pointers, whose sisters will teach you the meaning of humility, service, and love, while also being some of the toughest, most incredible women you could ever have the privilege of knowing. Nowhere will you find a college that so warmly and lovingly embraces each of its students, the leaders and honors kids, the athletes and RAs, the Quidditch captains and the Hillsingers, the undecided and the planners, the teenagers right out of high school, and the busy working professionals who made the amazing decision to go back to college. We are certainly a diverse, talented group, and one that I am proud to call my family. Whether it's been 1 year or two since we earned those diplomas, the classes of 2020 and 2021 have had to press on, to forge careers, to go to grad school, to go out to thrive in a tough world. Yet we're drawn back here to celebrate what we've accomplished and to express our gratitude for this community who has loved us and supported us since we all looked around at this beautiful campus and said, yeah, this is where I need to be. You know, I'm gonna sound like such an English major when I say that each human being has a story, but I'm just really happy that you all and Chestnut Hill come up a lot in mine. Welcome home, everyone. It's great to see you.
Thank you, Sam. It's now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Jeffrey Carroll, Associate Professor of Political Science, who will deliver the commencement address that was prepared by Dr. Jacqueline Reich, Associate Professor of Political Science, who at the last moment could not be present with us. It just kind of follows the pattern, doesn't it? Dr. Carroll.
Good morning. One more time, good morning.
Good morning.
Boy, there you go. Boy, Dr. Reich and I seem to collaborate in the most unusual ways. So I could take no credit for these powerful words, only the delivery. So please focus on the words. If we were on Zoom, I would say, can I get a thumbs up? Let me see a thumbs up. Yeah, no turn your cameras off today, huh? Dr. Reich wanted me to tell you in this note, I am so very sorry that I cannot be here with you today. I always enjoy celebrating commencement with our graduates, but this time I was going to be celebrating it with you, the students for whom I serve as dean. Please know that the graduates of 20 and 21 hold a special place in my heart. Since it was you, through countless demonstrations of courage and hard work that helped to show the true meaning of the Chestnut Hill College spirit. And today we are here to celebrate your fantastic achievement of finishing college during the COVID pandemic. And yes, the celebration is a little late. This delayed graduation does not take away from our pride in you as you surmounted tremendous obstacles to finish your degrees. To you all, I offer the cheer, hoosah. Okay, that's cheer only Dr. Reich could deliver, but I did my best. But no doubt, this is an unusual kind of graduation ceremony, and normally we're talking to our graduates when they are fresh from their last finals and literally moving on to their new lives. And this time, we are celebrating with graduates who have already been out in the world, who have moved into graduate school or into careers. You have interrupted the rest of your life to come back and let us honor you. And may I say, it is wonderful to have you back with us today. So, now that you're back with us at the college, we want to know, what are you making? Okay, Dr. Reich wants me to look around expectantly. That's a very specific direction. Okay, let me try that. Wait, oh, I see. Some of you thought I was asking how much you're making for a living. Well, of course, you earned a college degree to help you get a job. And you needed a bachelor's degree to make it into grad school if that is your path. But in the words of college founder Sister Maria Koskalog, you were also here to learn how to live. This statement by Sister Casca Loke has always been understood to mean that you are here at Chester Hill College to learn how to make a good life. So what we want to know is, what are you making with your life now that you are Chestnut Hill College graduates? Of course, many people helped you earn your degree. Perhaps it was through financial support. Perhaps it was by giving you a listening ear when you felt overwhelmed. Perhaps it was by having a conversation with new friends, with new outlooks. The knowledge that you gained in college was enabled by countless gifts of time, money, a lot of money, and energy, and a lot of energy. People helped you. Have you used your college knowledge to help you give back in return? Gratitude can encourage ripple effects of positive connections and kindness within our communities. And boy, our communities need more kindness, that's for sure. We hope that you are making a good life for yourself, you see the theme, by acknowledging all the help that you were given and that you are taking opportunities to help others in return. As you act to make your good life, you're also helping to make a good society. Society is a place where we all live and hopefully grow to our full potential. We know that a good society is made by actions large and small, by generous courtesies to other people, by taking the time to listen to others, by giving help where it's needed, in the ordinary day-to-day interactions that we make a difference. What are you making? Do you make time to reflect and take stock of yourself? Coming back to Chestnut Hill College today is an ideal time to do this. Recall yourselves as you were in your first year. Look how far you've come. Your time as students was an opportunity to expand yourself and to embrace new challenges and new ways of being, but the pandemic brought such difficult uncertainties. Yes, it was hard, but you persevered. You can take pride in just being here today as yourselves, as you have grown and made a life beyond college. Finally, are you making the places, environment in which you live better for us all? Environmental challenges can seem so daunting, but truly taking care of our physical spaces leads to a mindset of kinship within the world around us. So maybe you are picking up a plastic bottle in the Acme parking lot to recycle it, or maybe you are making a food choice that promotes sustainable agriculture. These individual actions help us to be in tune with our environment and to be alert to opportunities to help lessen the damage and improve environmental soundness. Attitudes of being a taker from nature and then replaced with attitudes of making a relationship with nature. So, as we gather to celebrate your outstanding achievement of graduation during a pandemic, 1 to 2 years after the fact, it is a good time to ask, what are you making? As you strive for professional goals and achieve personal milestones, keep in mind that you are recipients of an education that is grounded in values of connection, unity, and understanding. The world needs people with these values more than ever. You are Chestnut Hill College graduates. Come on. And you make us proud. Can I give both of you a thumbs up on that? See, you can't do that on Zoom. Thank you, everyone.
Dr. Carroll, thanks for being a great pinch hitter. I think you hit a home run. Exercise for the day. Now for the very long, long, long anticipated moment, the conferral of degrees on the classes of 2020 and 2021. Dr. Mark Meacham, Dean for the School of Undergraduate Studies, will present the candidates for the degrees Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Undergraduate Studies.
Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Undergraduate Studies, classes of 2020 and 2021, please stand. Sister President, the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Undergraduate Studies have completed satisfactorily the required courses of study at Chestnut Hill College and have complied faithfully with the standards of this institution. Therefore, as Dean of the School of Undergraduate Studies, I have the honor to present them for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science.
By the authority vested in me as President of Chestnut Hill College, under her charter from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Music, and Bachelor of Science in the School of Undergraduate Studies, to which you are recommended, admitting you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto throughout the world, signed and sealed in the Great Seal, in testimony whereof you will receive the diploma of the college.
As we call the names of today's graduates, we ask that you hold your applause as the candidates' names are read until all have received their diplomas. Your respect and cooperation will ensure the names of each graduate will be heard by their families and their loved ones. Kira Ann Altamare, summa cum laude. Reagan Elizabeth Baldwin, summa cum laude. Cleo Delilah Bell, cum laude. William Bethel. Aaron Bidding. Imani Monet Boggs. Stephanie Nicole Brogna, magna cum laude. Danielle Brooks. Zonitha Monique Brooks. Devin Bulwitz, cum laude. Christopher Bunn, summa cum laude. Cassandra L. Callahan, cum laude. Paige Therese Carter. Kareem J. Celestine. Sydney Charney. Alexia Marie Church. Kanija J. Clea. Emily Nicole Collier, magna cum laude. Caitlin Mary Coogan, cum laude. Samantha Virginia Covias, summa cum laude. James Owen Cutts. Mateusz Chibatul, cum laude. Colleen Donahue, magna cum laude. Jocelyn Nicole Amador Escalante. Victoria M. Fideco. Stephen Finori, cum laude. LaShonda Alicia Grant. Cordelia Jane Green. Sarah Isabel Hansel. Thomas Hughes. Alexis Marie Hunt. Erica K. Jolg, magna cum laude. Corinne Marie Chikoyi Kalala, cum laude. Emily Carl, magna cum laude. Caitlin A. Keough. Tiffany Alexis Kirby, summa cum laude. Lauren Klein, magna cum laude. Danera Littles. Alexis Paige McCaffrey, cum laude. Elizabeth McCormick, summa cum laude. Aaron Kelly McGuffin, cum laude. Jessica Maley. Jennifer E. Miller, magna cum laude. Marcel Cyrus Mitchell. Carrie Ann N. Mullen, summa cum laude. Hajra Najam, magna cum laude. Susie Q. Neiman, summa cum laude. Alexis L. Ober. Laura Anita Oliver. Elena Carmen Ortiz, magna cum laude. Stephanie Irene Owens, summa cum laude. Anthony Pavone. Kyle Phillips. Aaron Rafferty, magna cum laude. Thomas Francis Repsick, magna cum laude. Patricia Reedlova. Michael Robert William Roscioli. Kevin Michael Rossi. Sean Rowland. Jessica Lynn Scalen, magna cum laude. Christina Rose Simone. William Schaefer. Maya Sherelle Sharp. Jenna Diane Smith. Kaylee Stevenson. Zachary Zumagala. Lauren Thomas, summa cum laude. Sarah Jo Tucker, cum laude. Isabella Vicino, magna cum laude. Amanda Marie Vitel. Takara Patrice Wigfall, cum laude. Anissa Wilcox. Avery Catherine Wood, cum laude. Nicholas George Woody. A round of applause for all the 2020 Prince Vernon graduates.
I congratulate you, Bachelors of Art and Bachelors of Science.
And all bachelor's degree students, I have the honor of having you officially take your tassel from the right side. Please move it to the left side.
Please be seated. Dr. Elaine Green, Dean of the School of Continuing and Professional Studies, will present the candidates for the degrees Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Continuing and Professional Studies.
Candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Continuing and Professional Studies, please stand. Sister President, the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Continuing and Professional Studies have completed satisfactorily the required courses of study at Chestnut Hill College and have complied faithfully with the standards of this institution. Therefore, as Dean of the School of Continuing and Professional Studies, I have the honor to present them for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science.
By the authority vested in me as president of Chestnut Hill College, under her charter from the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you the degree Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science in the School of Continuing and Professional Studies, to which you are recommended, admitting you to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto throughout the world. Signed and sealed in the Great Seal, in testimony whereof you will receive the diploma of the college.
Before presenting the candidates for their diplomas, I ask that the members of the audience reserve their applause until all have received their diplomas. For the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science, Asma Bint Davis Abdullah, Jocelyn Aleo, cum laude. Deborah Arbuckle Schubert. Ayana Nakia Blunt. Aiton Lee Bolton. Jamesina A. Bonds. Larry Brooks, cum laude. Kenyatta Acho Burton. Kanisha Nakenya Chapman. Dana C. Cheatham. Tracy M. Clayton. Lalita S. Coleman, cum laude. Marilyn Colazzo, cum laude. Jessica M. Curran, summa cum laude. Kevin Clinton Curran, magna cum laude. Joanne Latish DeBoe, cum laude. Stacy Dorham, cum laude. Diana Evans. Ashley Danielle Evans, cum laude. Wendy Elizabeth Fallon, magna cum laude. Terry Joy Ford, magna cum laude. Melanie Freeman Everett. Joelle L. Gardner, cum laude. Dorian S. Gote. Danielle N. Hackney, magna cum laude. Renee Hartley. Jalea Hill. Michael Austin Horn, magna cum laude. Christine Jackson, cum laude. Alfred E. Johnson, Jr., magna cum laude. Anthony J. Johnson, magna cum laude. Fatma C. Kamara. Spiwi Kanyagara, summa cum laude. Rachel Nicole Kemp. Marie Lourdes Millard Lusson. Quincy Lyons, summa cum laude. Nicole Danielle Mayrant. Paula Miller, summa cum laude. Christina Minchala. Sabrina Renee Nelson. Ebony Janae Nichols. Charmaine Nixon, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Pagan, magna cum laude. Raymond Sherrell Lorenzo Phillips. Angela M. Plummer, magna cum laude. Adesha Relisa Plummer. Sherry Raffle. Claudette M. Ramsarup. Nicole Laquelle Reeves. Brittany Marie Richter. Carmen B. Rodriguez. Warren Lynn Ross. Diamond Seegers, magna cum laude. Fatma Sidi Sharif. Asia M. Smith. Nikita S. Thomas, cum laude. Nicole Alexandra Tripp, cum laude. Evelyn Marie Tucker, magna cum laude. Minosha Michelle Velez, magna cum laude. Stacy Washington. Linda Betts Watson, magna cum laude. Alisa Shanae Whitehead, cum laude. Tanisha J. Whitney, summa cum laude. Jasmine Williams, magna cum laude. Karima Williams. Rafiq A. Williams. Naja Atir Wright, cum laude.
I congratulate you, Bachelors of Art, Bachelors of Science.
bachelor degree students. Please officially turn your tassels from the right to the left, and congratulations.
Please be seated. My dear sister alumnae and brother alumni, accolades have been offered, honors bestowed, diplomas awarded, and tassels turned, all of which finally mark the end of today's commencement. What you have accomplished is indeed noteworthy, and the journey you have made to arrive here is truly unique. The degrees you have earned forever change you and the possibilities for your future, just as the experience of the pandemic has changed you and shown you your potential for resilience. Your families, friends, co-workers, classmates, professors are brimful of excitement for you and can hardly find enough words to express the joy they have in seeing you return to campus to embrace this moment. You have overcome immense obstacles and you have prevailed. In the face of multiple disappointments, you have chosen to keep your goal before your eyes and to move past disappointments. Throughout the past 2.5 years, you have demonstrated grit and determination and returned here today triumphant, ready to celebrate the future for which these tribulations have prepared you. You return here today much more mature than when you left suddenly in March 2020. You have grown and changed and met new challenges with tenacity and courage. Many of you have the job of your dreams or are on your way to one, are in graduate or professional school. Thus, you bring with you this morning a confidence born of experience and success beyond college. I am so glad you chose to come back for this belated celebration and so happy we were able to have it for you. As you leave the college today to continue the journey you have already well begun, I urge you to welcome others into your lives with that hospitality of heart that characterized your years at this college. While on campus, you lived, competed, participated, collaborated, ate, shared residence halls and classrooms with a microcosm of the global community. Students from different cultures, races, religions, and countries gathered on this campus, and together we lived in peace as we worked for the success of one another. We live in a very broken world. The events of this past weekend in Buffalo simply underscore our divisions. But at this college, all are welcome, no exceptions. All are respected, no exceptions. We do not judge, no exceptions. There is much I don't know, but I am convinced of this. The most profoundly powerful gift we can give another is to give our love without conditions, without expectations, without judgment. So go forth from here, holding hope high and believing that an active, inclusive love for every kind of dear neighbor without distinction will change the world. God bless you. I have just one brief announcement before we conclude. Because of our continuing concern for your safety, I would like to request that all of our guests stay seated until the graduates have left the tent. Graduates will be led back to the area where they rode this morning. We ask that guests with mobility concerns wait until after the initial exit of other guests so that we may provide you with the appropriate assistance. Once the crowds thin out, our staff will be able to assist you to the exits where golf carts can transport you back to your vehicle or shuttle for other parking areas. May I now ask everyone to stand for the alma mater and remain standing for the benediction. The alma mater will be led by Jennifer Miller, BS, Class of 2020, School of Undergraduate Studies. And the benediction will be offered by Carrie Ann Mullen, BS, Class of 2020, School of Undergraduate Studies. Immediately following the benediction, the platform party and the graduates will leave the tent. Please remain in your places until the graduates have left. Thank you.
Gracious God, how wonderful are the works of your hands. As we gather here today to celebrate a step forward in our journey of new beginnings, we ask you to continue guiding us along the way when we face times of change and adjustment. We pray you give us hope and positivity to accept change and keep moving forward. The classes of 2020 and 2021 have had an abundance of adjustments to make over the past 2 years. May you continue to push us forward. It has been hard to understand everything, God, and at times we felt defeated, but we are here. We have prospered and pushed ourselves to get wherever we are today, and I am proud of all of us for that. I ask that you continue to help us strive towards excellence and keep our steps firm during our ongoing journey. I thank you for gathering us here today to celebrate all of our milestones. Recent occurrences in our world have contributed to difficulties celebrating the small things in our lives, such as today's ceremony. We have gotten through death, sadness, grief, acceptance, defeat, and helplessness, along with all of the positivity that continued to shine through. We will keep proceeding, and I know we all can because of your guidance. God, thanks to your shining light, we have been able to see the road ahead of us. But I hope that the things that do stand in our way become examples of your limitless power and strength that you have given to all of us. I know you will let the sun shine on our faces and the wind on our backs, and I ask that you bless all of the graduates and allow us to find that strength to keep moving forward. During the times when we lose sight of your light and love, help us to remember that we are all a piece of your light when the journey of life gets dark. Help us to see your light in each other and in the world around us. Amen.
Thank you. perfect. So you just turn them off.
There should be another one there.
Yes.